Hello everyone, this video I'm going to talk about how to upload the CSV or text file in Oracle Apex application. Please look at the screen. I have a wizard with three pages. The first is upload file, the next is parse data, the last page is load data into the table. I choose the file, CSV file. Employee CSV is like this. Include employee number, employee name, job, manager, hire date, salary, commission, and department number. It matches the employee table and column. Then go to the next. I will see the employee CSV is the file name of uploaded file, and the preview the data of the CSV file. And I click the next button, then I can see the data loading finished. 15 rows processed. Then we can display the employee table information. Finished. How to achieve it? I can walk you through step by step. We go to the application homepage. Create the page. We can see the component go through to the wizard. I gave it a wizard name. We can see the wizard steps. Three steps. In this video, I have three steps. I change the steps name. The first step is the upload file. The second is the parse data. The last page is load data. We can see the three pages, 28, 29, 30. Then create the wizard. Run the application. You can see the wizard we created. Okay. Go to the first page is upload file. So go to the page 28. Upload file. Under the region, I will create the page items. I change the name as the file bar 28 bar. Next. Type I change to the file upload. Label file. Display as I select the block drop zone. I give it name is upload file. And here is this upload CSV or text file. Storage type is table Apex application template files. Layout template. Appearance I select because the upload file is required, so I select the required uploading. Okay. You can see the rest. Because the validation, the upload bar is required, so I switch to the on. That means the file is not now. I choose the CSV file and go to the next page. Okay, in this page, I will do the parse data using the Apex function. So here I select the interactive report and I using the type SQL query to display the CSV file. So is 28. We can see the select line number because the CSV file has 10 columns, so I select all the columns here, and the Apex application type file is the storage the CSV file. And I use the Apex application to pass the CSV file. Then the file upload content, the file name, add headers row Y, CSV enclosed, double quote. File char set, I use this char set. Maxi rows, we can change to the 30. About the application Apex data parse function, you can read the official document how to use it. Here I will not discuss about this. Okay. Save. We can see the CSV file preview like this. Next, I will insert the information CSV file to the table, employee table. Go to the page designer. Go to the process. In this process, I will use the create the. I don't need to write a SQL statement, so I directly use the type and date loading. But date loading, I need to define the date load and the shared components. Later, I will talk about this. I have already had two CSV load, so I select any of this CSV2. The file browse type, file browse is the 28. Here I will create the region, subregion, create a region here and load data, employee, E-M-P-L-Y, employee data. I use the interactive grid and I select EMP table. You can see the employee table information here. Finishing. But you look back the upload file page. In this page, I and upload the CSV text file. If the file is not CSV text file, how to check the file is CSV or text file? So I need to go to the page 28, and in this item I need to create the validation, and it's a valid file. Yeah, I use the function body ERC because I have already have it, so I can directly use it. Here I need to change to the 28 file. Okay. Please see, I will explain this code. We by name in VChat2, define VChat2 maximum size is 1000. And the file name is from the Apex application time files bill. Oh, please. 28 is, and application date plus assert file type is check the upload by is a CSV or not. If it is CSV file, then return true. Otherwise, return false. Every message I can. Yes, I. Oops. Associate item is 28. Wow. Please check. If I upload the PDF, we can see the error message will happen and display here. So I can remove it and upload the CSV, then pass to the next page and go to the last page. Then you can see in this page. Yes, go back to the previous page. In this page, I use the process load data using the data load definition. Go to the CSV2 and edit components. You can see the shared component data load definitions. I have already created the tool, so here I will create again. Yeah, CSV from scratch. Next, CSV3 and welcome. Table name is EMP because the last I will insert the, I will load the data to the employee table. Go to the next. You can see the upload file. I select the employee CSV, then next. You can see the create data load and the source name, source color map2. Yes, map2, and it is the source, the CSV color. And matches the column of the table employee. So here I create data load and then click the CSV3. In this here edit data profile, you can see the CSV format is CSV name CSV3. And because employee number is the primary case, so I click the pencil and edit primary case switched on, then apply changes. Okay. You can see the loading method. I use append. Append, you can see the explanation of the append, merge, and replace. Do you want to use? Depend on the situation of the project. Here, I use the append. Append rows to the table collection. If all man of more primary key columns defined in date bar, existing rows will not change and new rows will append it. So, apply changes. Go to the page 29. Processing load data. Because I use the previous CSV tool, here I use CSV 3 and save it. Here I can add a new row. Please look at this CSV file. I have already created the two new rows, Wendy and Cherry. Go to the application. I will upload again and see if it is already added to the table. So you can see the size has more than before. I click the next button. You can see the 17 and 18 is added to the preview. So I click the next button and see the new row Wendy and Terry has already added to the table. Thank you very much. Thank you for watching my video. If you are interested in, please subscribe me. If you have questions, please leave your comment below. I will respond to you as soon as possible. See you next video.